It's a piece of presidential history that has withstood the test of time. The resolute desk, handed down through generations, now the focal point of the Oval Office.
Just like a good rug that can really tie the room together, a desk can become an essential element in style and business. Take the Resolute Desk, for instance.
The Resolute Desk is the name of the desk that is in the Oval Office, even today. But the first person to use the Resolute Desk was Rutherford Hayes. It was a gift that was given to the United States when he was president. The gift was given by Queen Victoria.
Resolving to understand why a wooden desk can mean so much, you have to understand the history of one of the most famous pieces of White House furniture.
The British ship, the HMS Resolute, was on an excursion up around the North Pole, and it became embedded in some ice, and the crew was rescued, but they could not save the ship. And sometime passed, a year or so later, an American naval crew is up there, and they happen to notice that the ice has shifted. This British ship is now floating, and so they rescue it, take it back, and return it to England as a gesture of goodwill from the United States. And Queen Victoria was so moved by that that when the ship was decommissioned, she had wood from that ship made into a desk and gave the desk to the United States, and Rutherford Hayes gladly accepted it.
When it was presented, it was a partner's desk, which means that this part of it was open. It stayed that way until President Franklin Roosevelt wanted to use the desk, but he was concerned about the photographs and the press seeing that he had leg braces and used a wheelchair. So he ordered an insert. And what's interesting about this insert, if you look at it closely, you can see that it differs from the presidential seal, which is on the carpet and reflected in the ceiling. In this presidential seal, the eagle's head is turned towards the arrows and away from the olive branch. Well, during his administration, the military came to President Roosevelt and told him that there was an issue with the presidential seal and the eagle's head was turned the wrong way. So, unfortunately, President Roosevelt died before the peace arrived. President Truman had it placed in the desk in honor of President Roosevelt, but later made the announcement that the eagle's head in the presidential seal had been officially changed to be in sync with the Great Seal of the United States. And he said, the United States always looks toward peace, but is prepared for war. So you'll notice everywhere else, the eagle's head is turned towards the olive branch. And it's a beautiful desk. It's very low. It's low to the ground. And in fact, the line you see across the bottom of it was where the desk was raised for President Reagan.
Along the past few years into our presidential libraries, museums, and more specials, we started to notice some familiar furniture along the way. And why not? This wooden desk can become a familiar sight in uncertain times, and even offer inspiration or historic thoughts on those who sat down to sign their name to a document. On this old wooden ship that became a desk, and one of the most important pieces of furniture at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue in Washington, D.C. And maybe also scattered throughout the country, possibly at a presidential library and museum near you.
It was Jesse James' hideout just an hour outside of St. Louis, and it had a hand in the 1952 presidential election. Let's go to that Missouri cave where the Electoral College members went underground.
In the Show Me State in Stanton, Missouri, the story is surfacing of a dinner 170 feet below the ground in a place where Jesse James used as a hideout. And it's also connected to our 34th U.S. president.
Of course, it changes. The numbers of the Electoral College change with each state depending upon how many legislatures are in there at the time. And there was enough room for 13. Well, it just so happened that Rudy Turilli, my brother-in-law, was one of the 13. And he was able to go and be an elector. And so they had it back in here.
I'm sure it's the only time that Electoral College ever met underground.
Les Turilli is more than certain of an Electoral College member dinner inside this ballroom with 13 members who dined on steak and champagne before casting their votes in Jefferson City 2 days later in the 1952 presidential election.
I do remember it like it was yesterday. And once I saw the picture on social media, we used to have a picture here at the cave, and unfortunately we lost it when we had a flood in 17. But when I saw the picture on social media, it all came back to me. I remember all the hoopla and everything. It was a big deal, you know.
The dirt floor is gone, replaced with concrete. Also gone are many of the photos when flooding from the nearby Merrimack River left this ballroom under 8 feet of water. Elaine Davis remembers that electoral members meeting in the caverns for a most unique meal.
And of course, it never been happening in a cave before, for the one thing, that's a big thing. They've never had one of those electoral college decisions made in a cave, so that's unique.
They're printing the first commemorative presidential coloring book on hemp paper. We'll show you the Missouri company behind this.